In a world focused on the hustle and bustle, we often forget the incredible gift we possess, the gift of our own bodies. Treating your body like a temple means taking good care of it physically, mentally, and spiritually. It involves maintaining a healthy lifestyle, nourishing your body with proper nutrition, staying active, and also nurturing your emotions and spiritual well-being. It's about valuing your body and health as a precious gift from God. Part of nourishing your temple involves listening to your body's signals, understanding what your body needs in order to thrive. For example, I stay away from things like soy, gluten, and processed foods because I know what they cause. They cause inflammation for me, hormonal imbalance, and other negative side effects. In order to nourish my body, it's not safe or smart to feed myself foods that do the opposite. Now, I load up on fresh fruits, vegetables in their whole raw form. Now this can be a juice and a smoothie or a salad or enjoying them as is. I love how my body feels when I eat this way, and it makes me feel good about myself. Plus, my body rewards me with extra energy, glowing skin, and so much more. Just as a temple needs a strong foundation, your body needs a strong physical foundation. Regular exercise helps build and maintain muscular strength, endurance, and flexibility, providing a solid foundation for your body to function optimally. Regular exercise has been linked to a longer, healthier life. It reduces the risk of chronic disease, increases longevity, and enhances the quality of life in later years. Now, exercise isn't a one-size-fits-all. I prefer the term physical activity because it's all about moving your body. If you're someone trying to lose weight or trying to gain weight and build muscle, physical activity will look different depending on what your needs are or what your goals are. Regardless of what you do, it's important to involve moving your body regularly. Lately, I've been focusing on spending more time outdoors in the sun, getting vitamin D, and breathing in fresh, clean air. Taking deep breaths and breathing in clean air improves lung function. Exercise is also a natural mood booster. It releases endorphins, which reduce stress, anxiety, and depression. Plus, they promote mental well-being. Managing stress and practicing good mental health are vital for overall well-being and treating your body with the care and respect it deserves. Chronic stress can lead to increased stress hormone, hormonal imbalance, and reproductive challenges. Sleep disturbances like insomnia, unhealthy coping mechanisms like eating junk food as a form of comfort, weakened immune systems, making the body more susceptible to illness, among other health challenges. Learn healthy ways to cope and manage stress. I believe it's important to acknowledge your feelings and not suppress them. If you need to cry, it's okay. There's no shame if you're struggling or having a difficult time. Life happens to all of us. However, it's important not to stay there. Journaling is something I've practiced most of my life to just write down how I'm feeling at the time. I also like to go back and read old journal entries to remind myself of how far I've come and what God has already done for me. Because if He did it before, then He can certainly do it again. Getting adequate sleep and rest is also a part of treating your body like a temple. Allowing the body and mind to rest promotes the body's healing and repair process, and it strengthens the immune system. There's nothing wrong with working hard and going after your goals and the things that you want to achieve in life, but proper rest and recovery gives you the mental clarity and energy to do those things. God places priority on rest, as He Himself rested after He created the world in 6 days. There's so much restoration and rest. We don't always have to just go, go, go. In fact, there are studies that you actually get less done and performance quality goes down without proper rest. I created a nighttime routine. Now, this isn't something cute for social media, but building a routine puts you in a place of peace and relaxation. Each night looks different, but I had to set aside time away from social media, away from talking on the phone, just a time for me to reflect on the day, set goals for the next day, and also pamper myself. I like using products that are gentle and free from harmful chemicals because not only do I care about the foods that I eat, but I also care about the products I use on my body externally. In order to make rest, physical activity, and proper nutrition a priority, I had to build routines that work for me. Scheduling in time for the things that matter. Learning to set aside time for myself, caring about the things I was putting in and on my body, caring about what voices I allow to speak to me, only taking in things that add value to my life. These are the ways that I learned to treat my body like a temple. Understanding that this isn't an overnight process. It's not about perfection, but about taking steps each day to become a better you. Most importantly, love yourself. You cannot properly love others if you haven't loved yourself first. As always, if you made it all the way to the end of the video, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you on the next video, of course. Later, sis.